two is all we need.
Look up, Doug. Smile.
That's good.
We're dismantling the old net. We got Dale Reed up there cutting a few real important ties. Yeah, when that falls, it's dangerous. Okay, he's coming down.
Well, Mr. Woody, you said you found some pheasants there already.
What?
You found some pheasants already.
Well, I found the tracks. Okay.
Is this like being on safari?
Okay, here I go. You on?
I'm on. We're watching you come through the jungle.
A bit of a slope going on here.
So what are we doing today?
Well, we're cutting down. Hang on, watch yourself. We're taking down the old net, getting ready to put up a new one, thanks to the ACA. Alberta Conservation Association is helping to pay for fixing up our old pen. That'll do.
Well, now what we're doing is cutting the old net off. It's getting caught up at the top. It's not being nice. It's catching on everything. We were going to pull it off easier than this, but Dan and his dog are holding the ladder.
It's 2x4s coming out.
Yeah, I noticed.
Well, here we are in about the first week of May. We're out at the pheasant pen. We're drilling holes for the telephone poles. Look over here a little bit. You can see the poles that we'll be putting in. We're going to be standing them up later this afternoon. And there's Dan and his dog supervising. So these holes are going down, they're going down about 8 feet. So here's neighbor Norm clearing out for the last one. Our last post is going to be right there. And Norm's cleaning these up. Well, I better get my gloves on and get with it. So now what they're going to try to do is pick up that post off center and drop it in the hole. So we're going to see what's going to happen. That's Norm putting the first chain on. They got to figure this one out, and then we'll get back to you. So the operation is to push the end of the pole over to the hole. Put two 2x4s in the hole for the end to slide down. We're getting there. I'll have to get over there with a shot. Well, there's the end of it's up against the 2x4. Where the heavy danger starts. And it's in the hole. There we are. Exciting. dragging the next pole into the pen. There goes Norm. It's a long flipping pole. So Norm and everybody's getting the hell out of the way. There. It's in the hole. But look how high it is. Can you read it like that? Okay, on to the next. Well, a little bit of a rainy day, a lot of hard work, and the cement is all in. The poles are rigid now. Now, one more step coming up, and to cut the tops and level it. Anyway, one thing at a time. So we're busy putting up the outside fence, and what a job it was. So the guy's coming down, he's going to pick this up, and it'll be too noisy, so I'm going to turn it off. So here we are rolling up the wire that made the fence straight, and the wire that's laying on the ground, we're going to have a trench here and bury it so the foxes, coyotes, and everything else can't dig into our pen. We'll get a picture of it later if it all works out.
Going.
Are you ready? Okay, that's good.
Well, there we are. The net is halfway across, and it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, and we've got a couple of helpers here. We got to be, well, here, Norm and I, he was just telling jokes. Norm and I are up about 18 feet above the pen, and we're just putting all this wire in. You look over there, and there's Stacy. I'm gonna have to zoom in on that because it's a long way away. Oh, now he's waving. Good. He's the wire man. He's pulling his wire, our wire over there. I swing down here to the other end of the pen, and they're putting in the cranks to tighten the wires. As you can see, Dan the crank, cranking away, putting in a big pin. So there we are. We're almost done putting the wire up. And the pen, the next big step is trying to put a net over top of all this. Apparently it only weighs 450 pounds, so we'll have that done in 15 or 20 minutes. So what we got here is the old part of the pen, and we left all the carrageenah. The pheasants love carrageenah seeds and leaves and whatnot, and it's a place for them to hide. So we left that old part there and put the new great big net right over top.
Down here.
So here's a picture of the southeast corner. Ward Robson, the past president of the Red Deer Fish and Game, is just having a check. Well, what do you think of that, Ward?
Well, I think it's fantastic.
Yeah, well, that's good.
Yep.
We'll take a walk around the corner and see if we can find some birds.
All right.
Well, there you are. Welcome to another Where in the World is Woody? Here we are at the Red Deer Fish and Game Pheasant Pen. It's completed now after lots of work and struggling. It's hard to imagine that about four 70-year-old guys got this all done. It's 300 feet one way, 100 feet the other, with help from the ACA and a few other clubs. We've got it done. There are 400 pheasants in here, but right at the moment they're in the shade of all the pigweed in there. And all we have to do now is wait for kids to sign up for the fall hunting and let the bird get a little bit older. I'll show you some of it in a minute. Well, there you have it. That was Where in the World is Woody's video about our new pheasant pen. So until next time, good hunting, good fishing, and goodbye.